Isn't that cool?
Yeah. Can I try that? I could be using the force or something. I am using the force.
Now, this is the closest I get to doing magic. But this isn't actually a trick. This is a demonstration of static electricity, and it's a really fun way of getting your children interested in some really interesting phenomena. Now watch that.
Okay.
It's an ordinary pencil. Let me balance it there. I'm going to rub it on this cloth.
Are you going to pop it?
Well, I hope not. Now watch what happens to the pencil.
Ooh!
Isn't that cool?
Yeah. Can I try that? Okay, I'll rub it.
A little bit of a rub, yeah. I'll hold the cloth for you. It's like you're pulling it round, isn't it?
I could be using a force or something.
Well, I guess I think you are. When the balloon is rubbed against the cloth, it becomes charged with static electricity. And when things are charged with static electricity, they can attract or repel other things. If two things have opposite charges, they attract or pull towards each other. If two things have the same charge, both positive or both negative, they repel or push away from each other. It's a bit like the way that magnets can attract or repel each other, but static electricity is definitely not the same as magnetism.
Look, Mum, it's attracting it.
That's amazing, Hector.
It's actually attracting it.
You can see lots of interesting effects using static electricity. Here, a charged balloon is attracting a stream of water. The balloon has a negative charge and there are positive charges in the water which are attracted towards the balloon. It's the same with the pencil. There are positive charges in the pencil and these are attracted towards the negatively charged balloon. Everything contains electric charge, a mixture of positive and negative. And normally these cancel each other out. But when we rub the balloon with the cloth, some of the negative charge from the cloth rubs off on the balloon. The balloon gains a negative charge and the cloth is left with a positive charge. As you rub, tiny particles called electrons are rubbed off onto the balloon. Each electron has a negative charge and that's why the balloon becomes negatively charged. To do my so-called magic trick, what I did was charge the store up first by rubbing it. And then let it settle in the bottle. Then I bring my hand up gently. The charge in the straw is attracted to the charge in my hand. And it starts to move towards my hand. And David Copperfield is in the room.
Oh! Oh my gosh!
Goodness!
My goodness me!
They're almost flying, aren't they? Playing with static electricity is a genuinely magical thing to do if you've never tried it before. And it's amazing to think that just rubbing two things together can make these tiny electrons move from one object to another. I've been amazed at something that I thought I totally knew and understood. All the different activities we've been able to explore have genuinely fascinated me and my son.
I am using the force.
How do you reckon we could make a sound with that? Do you want to try pinging one of the glasses and see what sound it makes?